Hey, used to have a silver tooth and I was just a pup, yeah. Now I got some killers who got shotties with the pups. I don't wanna catch the feelings, I be trying to see what's up. Got a shorty clean the penis, I'm a diamond and a run it back. Used to have a silver tooth and I was just a pup. Now I got some killers who got shotties with the pup. I don't wanna catch the feelings, I be trying to see what's up. Got a shorty clean the penis, I'm a diamond and a run. First order of biz, no snitching. I try to keep it silent, but the kids don't listen.
While much of the country is struggling under cold temps and some of that white stuff, no such troubles here at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami. It is week 16 in the NFL, and we've got a good one in store, as it'll be the Dallas Cowboys taking on the Miami Dolphins. A happy Christmas Eve to all. What a good one we have in store as we are underway here in Week 16. Kevontae Turpin now from his end zone. And look at this. Right away, a loose football. Oh, one of the linebackers has got it. And they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line. Well, it's hard enough to play on the road in this league as it is, but to start on the road with a fumble on the opening kickoff, just not the precedent you obviously want to set.
Not at all, and now it's just words because they've talked about it all week. From the time they start game planning for this one, remember, going into hostile territory, we have to set the tone right in the beginning, and they do the exact opposite.
Here's a throw, complete right side to start things out. And it'll head out of bounds inside the 10, mark it down at the 9. 14 yards there on the first play from scrimmage.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open. Just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
And he's going to pull his way down to about the 1 yard line. A good run on first down, and now they contemplate a second and goal situation.
That's a great run right there on first down. Didn't quite get into the end zone, but now you've set yourself up for at least two, maybe three more shots from close range.
Second and goal from the one.
Let's go! Hey, come on, two! Come on!
Mostert. No signal, and now they say he did not get in. He is stonewalled at the one. They're held again, and do we have a goal line stand brewing? It's third and goal. A couple extra tight ends are in, third and goal from the one. Now this time, two is going to throw it. They'll roll him out right. And he will take it in for a Dolphins touchdown. Tua Tagovailoa taking it in from a yard out. And the Dolphins get the upper hand as they're on the board first here this afternoon. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And it's now a 7-0 game. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. So Prescott of the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 19-yard line. So the drive's going to start with Pollard. And he stopped right at the 25 after a gain of 5. This defense for the Dolphins, they really played well a week ago in that win over the Jets.
And one of the key things you always look for when you're evaluating a defense is how opportunistic are they? How many takeaways do they get per game? And how about last week's game? That number, 6. Absolutely phenomenal performance. They were on top of their game right from the first snap.
Looking to throw, Prescott. Escaping the pressure right. And
get rid of it.
You talk about this Miami defense.
They really played well a week ago in that win over the Jets.
One thing you always look for when you're evaluating a defense, how opportunistic are they? How many takeaways do they get? How about last week's game? The number was 6. Phenomenal performance.
They come up now 3rd and 5 following the incomplete pass. Here's Prescott.
That's dumped off to Pollard.
And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks.
And already down 7-0 after the touchdown a minute ago, so a 3-and-out here would not be ideal for them. Nice job finding his receiver there, and they get the first down.
And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. 13 yards and a first down, Cowboys.
That's a nice run right there, able to get to the outside. And so many times defenses say, okay, we've got you hemmed in. But if you're running the football, at least you know where everyone is coming from. You don't have to worry about the backside at all. That allows you to run with a little bit more confidence as you traverse down the field.
So after 2 first downs, they get another here. 1st and 10 at the 45. On play action, Prescott. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's 2nd down.
Brandon, we saw these defenders fly into the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
2nd and 10.
Prescott now. He's got his man. It's Gallup. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins 26. That one nearly 30 yards, 29 officially. So now 1st and 10 as they've crossed into Miami territory at the 26-yard line. They run straight ahead here with Pollard. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. 2nd down. Play action now, Prescott. And that'll fall incomplete. He was hit just as he let that go. And now it's 3rd down.
They've given him some different looks here defensively in the early going. He's only hit 2 of his first 5 passes. With a big 3rd down coming up, he's hoping he's got a play dialed up that can take advantage of whatever the defense throws at him.
An 8-play drive to this point. So here's play number 9 on 3rd and 7. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. And that is incomplete.
Even the greats in this game, and he certainly qualifies as one of them, they're going to have trouble if they continue to throw into double coverage.
He better be careful. Throwing in too much double coverage might have a couple of them picked off.
And his kick is right there. It's good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3.
So both teams come away with points on their opening drives. Now they still trail. They answered the touchdown with a field goal, but at least able to break that goose egg here early.
And that is what's important, right? Because they didn't let that initial touchdown go unanswered. Took the ball themselves, moved it downfield, and put it through the post for 3 points. Game on.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive.
This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up 6 the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they're both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
Now a play fake. Here's Tagovailoa. He'll let this go deep for Waddle. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. intercepted. Picked off by Marquise Bell. And the Cowboys are going to take possession here at their own 47-yard line. Oh, they tried to take the deep shot there, but this defense up to the task.
And a lot of times when you air a ball out like this, if it does get intercepted, there's going to be a lot of space out there to set up a return. And remember, you've got five big offensive linemen out there playing on their feet in open space. Not a skill most of them possess that allows for extra yardage on the return.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. They start near midfield following the interception as they begin first and 10. And he's fortunate to get anything from that. Give him a yard up to the 49. Prescott now on second down. Flushed out right. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away. Charles, he doesn't seem to be particularly in tune with his receivers, just 2 for 7 throwing the football, but he did seem really locked in before the game.
Yeah, and that has to do with receivers sometimes. Sometimes the defenders knock them off their route, and you're usually pretty precise. 1, 2, 3 cut, ball's out of his hands to the receiver. In this case, might be off by half step either way. They've got to find a way to get back in sync.
On third down, it's Prescott. And a big loss here as he's taken down.
Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game.
Okay, I'm not sure you could actually draw a better pass rush than that one right there. Nowhere to go outside. He had to keep backing up and backing up and backing up. Eventually dropped for a huge loss.
Oh, fighting off the defender. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. Good blocking there. Nearly sprung him. As it is, it'll go as a 19-yard return. And it'll be Dolphin football. First down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive.
And we'll see if they can bounce back from that last drive. In particular, if they can bounce back at the quarterback position, Charles, after throwing their first interception of the ball game.
Yeah, some guys, you know they're going to want to try and get a big play right away and take control back. Others, they're going to look to hit a couple shorter passes and get a little momentum back that way.
But for the defense, that goal's not changing a bit. They want another pick.
You're exactly right about that. In fact, you've got to watch them a little bit because in coverage, they may cut down their gaps a little bit, maybe their splits a little bit in order to try and get to the ball even faster.
Here's second and 10.
And now a timeout called by the Cowboys defense. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter.
Now a second and 10.
Hey, 21-10.
Tua gonna throw. That one caught by Tyreek Hill. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. Chain on first and 10. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. The Dolphins at 9-5 now on the year. And they come in feeling pretty good after back-to-back victory, CD.
And I thought that they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their discipline, their resilience, all on display in that victory.
So the first down run lost a couple. Now they come up second and 12. From the gun, it's Tua. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
You look at this Cowboy defense.
They come into this one in the bottom half of the NFL against the run, number 19 overall.
Stopping the run, that's been an issue for them all season long. Aren't you glad that you're not coaching the defense right now?
I'm very glad. They said that they've seen it in doses, but very, very small doses.
Yeah, you've got to be consistent. It's down in and down out, being able to play it, understand what you have to get done, and finally stop some people, put them on the ground.
Father, low. Hey.
Off of play action, Tagovailoa. And he will go down, a Cowboys sack. Looks like a 9-yard loss, and it also brings up fourth.
We've watched this a long time, and I still don't believe we get it. Third and long. Why are you calling play action?
Because they're not going to.
So on fourth down, here's Jake Bailey to punt for the Dolphins. Kevontae Turpin deep for the Cowboys.
They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. Taken in at the 11. It's a return of four following a 42-yard punt. And the Cowboys will be backed up to start the drive. They'll have it first and 10. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. As the season winds down and you look at them in totality, you know, the offense has struggled. And now this is intercepted. My goodness. And he will bring it back to about the 11-yard line.
And they'll take possession already in the red zone and in a great spot to add points to the scoreboard.
And Brandon, how many times have we seen a defense with a lot of field behind them get even more aggressive, right? They feel like they've got them not pinned down, but in a favorable spot for them, and they took advantage of it there, got a nice interception, and set up their offense in great shape.
Ready.
Now a first and 10 at the 11.
After the turnover, it's Tua. And he's going to be taken down, sacked back around the 18-yard line.
Osa Odighizuwa with the effort there to earn the sack.
It's interesting, partner, that most defenses try and guard the 35-yard line actively because they think the way kickers are nowadays, about a 52-yard field goal, they're kind of giving up points. But you get even deeper into territory, you get into the red zone, they're going to guard it even more, which means more pressure, more blitzing.
Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. Tua sets up to pass it. And this throw incomplete.
And the defender all over him that time, but it's going to lead to third down.
Well, partner, guaranteed they approach this play with the idea of making up ground to make third down manageable. Unfortunately, with that incompletion, right back where they started on the last snap. Now they need a big third down play in order to pick up the yardage needed.
On third down, here comes Mostert.
And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. That winds up being a 4-yard loss and leads to fourth down.
Jason Sanders on for the field goal. A 39-yard attempt.
The kick by Sanders is good. And they push the lead up to a touchdown now at 10-3.
So the interception set him up a terrific field position, but 3 points, the end result.
Yeah, we can make this one pretty simple, partner. You always want to end drives with points, but that's one that you're going to look back on and probably say, we should have done better there.
Now after the field goal, Bailey will kick it away.
And not willing to risk another fumble, he'll sit on this one. It's a touchback.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive.
And for this offense, Charles, you got to think kind of crucial here to put something together on this drive, because remember last time out, they threw the interception on the very first play.
And you can't afford to let this defense keep building any more momentum. They're playing awfully well, and they're awfully confident right now. To me, it's time to attack and take some of that momentum back. But make sure you're selective in doing so. Understand where you want to throw the football and make sure it's open before the ball leaves your hands.
Here's a second and two now from the 33. Here's Prescott. Swinging this out for Pollard. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
Well, that was a pretty favorable situation there. What would you call that, second and manageable? Smart play, too. Didn't force it downfield when he didn't have it. Just checked it down. Let him get the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
They'll go with Pollard here on first down. Now he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Now Prescott. It's hauled in by Brandon Cooks. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins 42. Last play, they got stuffed at the line. Different story here, over 20 yards.
Brandon, what's even more impressive is that came against double coverage. He gashed them with that reception, even with the extra focus that he drew from the defense.
Prescott on first down. On the out route, it's Lamb with a grab. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
Hey, kill.
A first down throw for Prescott. His throw incomplete.
Well, a momentary speed bump there with that throw, partner. The defense had other ideas, and they're trying to mount a small stand before this drive reaches the end zone.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. They'll throw again. Prescott. Oh, and his early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted. Picked up by Xavier Howard. And the Dolphins are going to have it here as they'll start at their own 7.
When a team's turned it over 3 times in the first half, we just look at the offense and say, guys, what are you doing? But instead, we really should be looking at the defense. They've created the takeaways. 2 interceptions, 1 caused fumble. They played awfully well swarming to the ball here in the first half.
The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. They got the ball now following a big play, keeping the other guys out of the end zone. Now they'll start deep in their own territory, first and 10. Setting to throw on first down is Tua. Quick hitter to Jalen Waddle.
And a productive gain out to the 14 after starting at the 7. It's a gain of 7. So that one, a hold right guard.
And you understand why offensive and defensive linemen probably go to martial arts schools and work on their hands so often, because that can be the make or break difference on a play. This time he had to grab a jersey in order to make the play happen. Got caught for the penalty.
All right.
Here's Tua. That one complete to him. And they work this out past the 25. A well-executed 22-yard gain.
Certainly no settling into the drive there. They came right out on the first play and attacked the middle of the field for a big gainer and a first down.
H.A. now up the middle. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
Good yardage there on first down. Exactly what you want. Get yourself set up to keep making first downs. Keep the clock running. And if they're smart, you're starting to milk the clock. No hurry before you run your second down play.
Our score 10-3 with 2 minutes remaining in quarter number two. Maybe a good spot to take a shot here. Second and a yard from the 34.
Solo left Zion. Help!
They give to A-Chain on the option. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. That one good for 13 and a Dolphin first down. And if his coaches are correct, we're going to see a lot more runs like that from this young rookie going forward.
And you know, slapping each other on the back up in the boots right now? The scouting department, because they really recommended this guy highly, and he's justifying their faith in him.
Jalen Waddle. And he's all the way down to the 13-yard line. It's a big play there for Miami. So that about the shortest pass a quarterback can make, but it winds up going for a bundle.
Yeah, let's face it, in the stats, it sure looks like a heck of a throw, doesn't it? It's almost like in baseball, when you get that little Texas leaguer that turns into a double, you would think that you hit it off the wall. Big time play for him on a short little pass.
And he's able to get this down to the 5-yard line before he's out of bounds. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and two. They'll come out in the pistol. Right back to A-Chain on second down. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1-yard line. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now as the clock stops here with 46 seconds remaining in the first half.
First and goal at the 1-yard line.
In motion, Hill.
Solo left Zion. Solo left Zion.
Throwing now is Tagovailoa. Back of the end zone. Could he get his feet down? No, it's incomplete.
Brandon, some of those windows to throw the football that exists when you're between the 20s, they don't exist when you're this close to the goal line. But as a former DB, I liked it closer to the goal line. Tighter windows made it easier to cover people, actually.
A-Chain. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down.
I thought they were onto something with their play call. It kind of went in reverse a little bit. Threw it on first down, then ran it on second down. Not successful either way. What play call do they come up with here on this important third down try?
This Cowboy defense trying to hold them out of the end zone. They've run it to third and goal. They fake the handoff. Now Tua out to his left. And he'll take this into the end zone for the Dolphins touchdown. Tua Tagovailoa with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Dolphins go nearly the length of the field and finish it off with 6 points. And his kick is good, but flags come in. Looks like we're going to get a roughing call here on the follow-through. And they'll accept that penalty. After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. A little under 30 seconds to go. We'll see how they play it here on first and 10. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Flush to his right. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Emmanuel Ogba in there to bury him for a loss of 11. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Cowboys 3. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number 3. ...17-3 the score as we resume action for the second half on EA Sports. Berrios going to bring this out of the end zone. And all in all, a pretty solid return. Nearly got it to the 35. They'll mark him down officially at the 34. First down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive. And they've got the lead. CD, what do you think the message was at halftime?
I think the message was too drastic, I think, at the half, though, that they need to change things too much. I do think the offensive line could play a little bit better. I think they'll try and help them out more. They'll probably keep a tight end in a few more times and maybe add a running back to the formation to pick up those pass rushers because they probably allowed a few too many sacks for comfort in the first half.
Let's go. 32 Stinger.
Play action, now it's Tua. He dumps it off to A-Chain. And they'll get this just to the 47, 1 yard gain.
Caught that look from you there, partner. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his first catch, I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
Tua wants to throw it on second down. That's going to be caught by Waddle. And down he goes at the 49, a 3-yard pickup.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield. I spy a couple of extra defensive backs on the field for Dallas.
Cowboys in the dime on third. Two is going to change things up. And the pressure gets there, and Tua is going to be taken down. Mike.
Micah Parsons has now recorded 10 sacks on the season.
The Dolphins will send out the punter now as he'll punt it away for the second time. His first punt, 45 yards. This looks good as well. Taking it about the 16. 42 yards on the punt, just two on the return. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And Charles, they're certainly still right in this game, but they need that offense to wake up and in a hurry.
Yeah, I like the way you put it. They certainly did seem to sleepwalk a bit in the first half. Now that their defense has done its job, it's their turn now to go out and try and get some points.
It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4. Here's Prescott. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to 1.
Now a shotgun handoff to Pollard. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. 55 yards rushing now on 8 carries for him so far. On play action, Prescott. And the Dolphins rush gets home. Down he goes. Emmanuel Ogba able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon. And that's his second sack in this one.
And you just can't ask a defensive end or an edge rusher to play any better than what we're seeing right now. And partner, it's still just the third quarter. I'm thinking he's not done yet. Even if he's not getting a sack, he's bringing a lot of pressure to the pocket.
And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. They toss it down to Pollard. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up third down.
If these guys are going to chop into that deficit, they got to do a much better job in the run game. Caught behind the line of scrimmage, no yardage will be found.
Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. And he's going to be brought down here in the backfield.
The pressure from multiple guys there as they bury him for a big 9-yard loss.
Out now comes the Cowboys punter as he'll kick it away for the second time. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. So a good punt there, but a nice return of 11 yards. And they will take over first and 10. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. This crew had to punt last time they had the ball, but when you've got a lead like this, you content to play the field position game?
You are to an extent, especially if you like your defense, because you have the lead, you've been controlling the game. But why put them in a tougher spot? You want to get out there and get something done on offense and maybe take command of this game yourself.
Solid way to start the drive. 13 yards, picking up the first. Hill going to go in motion right. Here's a fake on the jet sweep, and instead a give up the middle. And he's going to be brought down inside the 45 at the 43. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Now this throw caught left side. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line.
Well, timeout here, an injured player, and that's Jalen Waddle, who seems to be in some discomfort.
So now, following the big play, they've got a first and goal all the way down at the 10. And a short pickup there, down to about the 9. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
One more time with A-Chain.
And he's going to pull his way down to about the 1 yard line. A nice run there. 8 yards moves him much closer to the goal line now for third down.
A lot to praise on this drive, obviously. I know you're seeing what I'm seeing. Those guys up front, they're getting it done.
Doesn't matter what play is called, they are handling their business at the line of scrimmage and dominating right now on this drive.
Big play coming here. It's third and goal. Now a play fake. Here's Tagovailoa.
He's got it. Touchdown, Dolphins. Tyreek Hill. Touchdown number 15 on the year.
And the Dolphins are able to extend their lead in the final seconds of this third quarter.
Extra point up and good by Sanders. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown.
Here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get 2 more possessions.
Second and 7.
Prescott from the gun. Steps away to his left.
Oh, that'll be incomplete. Well, he took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring out the third down.
They lead big, and a major part of that has been how they've taken their play to a whole new level this second half. No points allowed since the break, and you can add another incompletion to the total number that they forced in this runaway contest.
And this offense on third down today, they've only converted once in 4 tries. This is 3rd and 7. To throw is Prescott.
Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he will have a Cowboys first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Now Prescott.
And this is incomplete. Very lucky to get that one back. That nearly picked. It's 2nd down now.
And that's another play that's painted the picture of this game overall. It's been a blowout. It's been continually fueled by big turnovers and stops for one side and an inability to advance the ball from the other.
2nd and 10 now from the 27. Prescott yet again.
He finds his man, Pollard.
And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 11 yards and a Cowboy first down.
You cannot write these guys off just yet, not with a quarterback like that under center.
You mean it actually crossed your mind with him running the team that you could actually maybe write this game off?
Not yet.
Not a chance. Not with him. We've seen it too many times.
He'll find Lamb. That's complete. He's across midfield. Still on his feet. CeeDee Lamb. Touchdown. CeeDee Lamb. 62 yards. And the Cowboys are finally into the end zone here in this fourth quarter. Extra point right down the middle. And that cuts the lead to 24-10. The kick team out there for the Cowboys as they run up to send this one away. Berrios now from his end zone. And this return will net positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line.
At their own 27-yard line.
First down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive. Now, there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs to keep up with your theme there, playing keep away. First downs, they can't touch the ball.
That stop for a loss made by Damone Clark from its linebacker spot. So now they have to contend with second and 13 after the first down run goes backwards. Tua sets up to pass it. And, oh, he's unable to hold on to that defensively. A potential game changer, but it falls incomplete.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go three and out here and get the football right back because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
Ready. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Tua going to throw. These guys running back out of the backfield, and he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. A big play there as they get the conversion on third and 13. Still throwing the football here, even with the big lead.
Yeah, I know you and I came up in a different era, and we think about sportsmanship and all that. Other people think about fantasy points and getting their numbers. That's all they care about right now. Yeah, ready.
A give up the middle to A-Chain.
And he's got this one across midfield in the Cowboy territory. DeMarcus Lawrence in on the tackle. Now I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
Going to the air, Tagovailoa. And this one is incomplete.
It's another zone defense. It looks like it's open for possibilities, but they did a nice job patrolling the middle of the field and forcing an incompletion.
Ready. They come up now, third and five, following the incomplete pass. Here's Tagovailoa to throw. Open man is Hill. He's got it. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping him from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. The offense here not budging. They're going to fight for it on fourth and inches. They're going for it. Here's Tua with it. And it's going to be batted down. It will go the other way with the football. The Dolphins can't convert on fourth down. And the Cowboys defense is going to get them the football back. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. The last time out, they had to march almost the full length of the field for their touchdown. So here, much easier, Charles, with this better starting field position.
I love your sarcasm, but I love even more your observation, because look, what they did last time out, now with a shorter field, they should have a lot of confidence that they're going to put more points up on the board.
Here's second and 10.
Here we go, 46. Here we go, kill. 46.
Prescott off play action. And Cooks has it over the middle. It'll go down as a gain of 6. And now we've got a 3rd and 3. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give them that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle them after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
And oh, he's just going to be short here, barely. Maybe by a half a foot. It'll be 4th and inches. Desperation time. Prescott on 4th. That is caught. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30.
Well, certainly those are the types of mistakes they're trying to avoid as they attempt to protect this lead late in the game.
And let's face it, they're hoping that this one doesn't cost them in a significant way. Yeah, one guy committed a penalty, but now the entire defense has to pay the price and try and rise up and overcome it.
Pollard gets it off the option. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, 2nd and 2. They come up now on 2nd and 2. On 2nd down, it's Pollard. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line.
Javon Holland on the tackle. 1st and goal, Dallas.
2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got it 1st and goal as they look to punch in a late score.
Here we go, 1st and goal.
They'll try to throw now. Prescott being chased out left toward the pylon, but it's incomplete.
Limited time left on the clock after that incompletion, so I think both sides are going to savor every second to prepare before the next snap, because once the ball's in motion, it may be a nonstop push to finish this drive off.
And he will fight his way into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Tony Pollard with his 13th rushing touchdown on the year. And the Cowboys have made it a one-score game again here in the 4th. They do tack on the extra point as well. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this 4th quarter. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away.
Berrios going to bring this out of the end zone. And he returns this to the 22.
The Dolphins take over 1st and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. Well, they can smell victory, partner. They can see it on the horizon, but certainly we're not done yet here. Defense still has 3 timeouts, and obviously this is a very slim lead they're holding on to.
And let's face it, the easiest way to get this done, challenge your ground game, challenge your offensive line, your tight ends, your receivers, anyone who's going to lay down a block. Don't let there be penetration, because they're going to stack the line of scrimmage and maybe bring extra people to the ball. If you can do that, make them burn their timeouts, run out the clock, life will be good. But if you really want to gamble a little bit, a quick play action, quick throw, might be able to get it done. Just make sure it's not incomplete and stop the clock.
Coming up here, looking for 3 yards to pick up the first.
They'll run for it with A-Chain. And he will have a 1st down as they get him to the ground at the 37. Now the defense going to use the 1st of their timeouts, as he'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the game.
First and 10 at the 37-yard line.
5 points of contact necessary at this stage as they'll run on first down. And he is going to have a Miami first down, and the Dolphins are going to win the football game.
It's a pickup of 13, and with that 13 yards, this ball game just about over.
First and 10 at the 49-yard line.
And they take a knee. Cowboys signal for their third and final timeout as they get it with just 19 seconds left on the clock. Down to an knee goes Tua, and that should just about do it. And maybe the outcome of this with Charles would have been different, but ultimately time runs out on the comeback, so it falls short, and they hold on to win this by just one possession.
Not the fourth quarter they wanted, but they did earn the win, and they'll be happy about that, and they should be. Now they're going to go back to practice, see what they can do to prevent a future lead from slipping away like this one was.
So for the Dolphins, it's an important win for their playoff hopes as they hit the 10-win mark now at 10-5. And they'll hit the road next week to take on the Baltimore Ravens. Meanwhile, for Dallas, they're guaranteed now a sub-500 season as they fall to 6-9. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew here at EA Sports, I'm Brandon Gordon, saying so long, everybody.